God bless you all. Indeed, what a mighty God we serve. Look at us. Look at you. Look at me. What a mighty God we serve. God is good. And all the time, God is good. Praise be the name of the Lord. I want to start this morning by extending happy birthday and blessings and best wishes to Bishop Jethro Hart, right here from right here in Jamaica. Today, the man of God celebrates his birthday anniversary, and I give God thanks for him and for the work he has done. And indeed, his work and worth is recorded in heaven, and God bless him. This morning, I'm going to share with you a portion of what I have shared recently. Passage of scripture taken from Jude. And you know, Jude had one chapter. So I read Jude 24 and verse 24 and verse 25. Jude verse 24 and verse 25. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you blameless before the presence of his glory with great joy. To the only wise God, hallelujah, our Savior through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to glory, be glory, majesty, dominion, and authority before all time and now and forever. Amen. I am speaking with you on a simple topic. Our God is able. And when we read scriptures and we find so many passages of scripture that show us, tells us, prove to us the capability and the ability of God. Jude said, now unto him who is able to keep us from falling. And now, the word now is really, really significant in this verse. It is not saying recently only, nor is it say then, nor is it saying once upon a time. It is saying now, currently, right now as we speak, right now as we are in devotion, now to the only wise God, to our God who is able. And this morning I rejoice and I give God thanks because we serve our able God, a God who is far above all, and he understands and he hears and he listens and he responds to our calls. The only wise God. The word of God says, who is able to keep us from stumbling. He is sufficient for you and for me, my brothers and sisters. He is sufficient for all of us in that he is able. And let us for a moment substitute the word able and say our God is capable. Our God has the ability to. Our God knows how to keep us from falling, keep us from stumbling, to preserve us, to protect us, to prepare us. Praise be the name of the Lord. Now to the God who is able. And if you are not able, my friend, then you are unable. But we serve a God who is able to keep us, to hold us, to protect us, to sustain us, to guide us, to guard us from falling and from stumbling, as this version says, and to present us blameless before his Father's throne, and to give to us the opportunity to accept salvation. And you and I know, yes, my friends, you and I know that salvation has made a difference in our lives. Hallelujah. 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 Thanks be to God. My God is able. He's able to take care of me. My God is able to take care of you. Therefore, if our God is able to take care of us, then he's the only wise God. And like I shared recently, if you take out wise and look at the word opposite to wise, foolish, we are now saying that all other God is a foolish God, are the foolish gods. Because the word of God tells us that he is the only wise God. He's the God who knows before we were born. The writer said, he was before you and I was born, he knew us, yet he loved us. He knew us, yet he had committed himself through his words to take care of us. And everything else, and anyone else who want to come and to present to us anything else other than salvation, I want to say to you that our God is the only wise God. Hallelujah. And he will present us blameless before his Father's throne. What does that mean? The gift of salvation. The gift of redemption. He has, the only wise God has redeemed us. Bring us into the fold. And all that I'm saying to you today, my friends, is a current message. It's not a recent message. It's a current. It's a now-a-day message. It's presently. Because the word of God said, now! Hallelujah. Now unto him. Now unto him. And everyone can testify about your now experience with God. He shows up. Just when we think that all is gone, he reaches out his hands. I am saying to us this morning, I am saying to us today, that we are privileged. We are blessed. And I want to use another word. We are special. Because this God is our God. And this God is the only wise God. Yes, others will say, will call themselves or claim to be God. But no one else can touch my heart like he do. He's the God of yesterday. He's the God of tomorrow. But he's the God of today also. The now. Now unto him. This capable God. This God with full ability. Full assurance to take care of his own. He has a time and the time and time enough for us. Back here in Jamaica, there are times when you would call a number, a telephone number, and said, I'm sorry, the person you are calling is unavailable. I don't know if you have that experience, whichever country you are listening now or tuning in from. I don't know if you have that experience, but we here in Jamaica have that experience several times. The person you are calling is not available. Please hang up and call again. Can you imagine, my friends? Can you imagine? This is not, and I repeat, not our Christian experience. This is not the communication experience, the contact experience with God. He's always available for us. And we can bring our hearts broken, we can bring our thoughts, we can rejoice, we can communicate with God because he's now available. And when we communicate with God, we can tell him, we can talk to him, we can be assured that he will answer us. We can be assured that the gift of salvation is available to us. And when I read the passage of scripture, I say, thank God, not just for the gift of salvation. Yes, he brought salvation to us, but it is wrapped up in a package, redemption. I am redeemed. When my burden of sin was high, I am redeemed. When everything seems hopeless, unsure, stale, not new, I am redeemed. You are redeemed. When our burdens of sin were high, we are redeemed. When our souls condemned to die, the only wise God knows what to do. Hallelujah. And he steps in on time and gives to us salvation. So Julian is writing, he said, now to the, he is able to keep us from falling. And I think of the ability of God. And it, and my finite mind, my finite understanding cannot be fathomed. The ability of God, the goodness of God, the blessings of God. All because he took my sin. Even before I was born, even before you were born, God chips in the ability, his ability to save us, to redeem us, to bring us back to him. So I want to say to us this morning, it's Worship Wednesday. And I want to say to us this morning, we worship. We bow down and worship Jehovah. We bow down and worship the only wise God. We bow down and worship the most capable God. We bow down and worship that no one else can compare. No one else is like unto him. There's no doubt in my mind. There's no uncertainty in my mind. Today is a new day. And when we face each day, we are facing it because he is the only wise God. But the word went on to say, to him be honor, glory, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. To him be honor, glory, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. You know what it is saying? Forever and forever. Oh God, you are. You are. Not you were. Not you was. Not you might have been or should have been. You are the present help in time of trouble. You are. Hallelujah. You are the God who knows what to do, when to do, how to do. And so I just want to encourage us as I close. I just want to encourage us to be encouraged. Be assured that we are serving the capable God, not the incapable God like some people do. And I have no apology for that. It is my experience, and I'm certain that it is your experience too, that our God is able, our God has the ability to, our God knows what to do. And we are talking about the only wise God. And you and I understand very much the word only. No one else. No one else can touch my heart like he does and they have done. No one else. There's no one to compare with God. The word of God says he is the only wise God. And I am comforted with his words. God bless you, my friends. But I can't close my devotional talk to you without saying a word to those who are tuning to ZJoyVI Gospel Radio, whether you are watching or listening. My word to you is, what is your experience like? Are you experiencing fellowshipping, worshiping the only wise God? I put it to you that if the only wise God is not a part of your daily experience, I put it to you that whatever you do, whomever you are focusing on, he has or she has no ability to None. Because our God is able to. So I want to say to you, I invite you to come to know Lord Jesus Christ. I invite you to reorganize your life. I invite you to come into this consciousness that our God is the only wise God. And anything else or anyone else can never ever compare with the capital G-O-D. Everything else is a common G-O-D. It has been my experience for many, many years that he's the only wise God. God bless you. The Lord bless you. And I trust and pray that you will come into this experience, my unsaved friends, my non-Christians friends. I trust and I pray that you will come into this experience. You will be assured. You will come into this understanding that he is the only wise God. Father in heaven, we thank you. We thank you for your words. We thank you for the ministry of ZJoyVI. We thank you for the ministry and everyone that is a part of this ministry, our evangelist Angela Burns. We thank you for the opportunity that we can reach so many persons across the world, in so many countries of the world. We thank you, Lord, for salvation. We thank you for the experience of salvation. We thank you for redemption. When the burden of sins were high, you redeemed us. When our souls condemned to die, you redeemed us. For the price we could not pay, we cannot pay, we'll never ever be able to pay. So we want to thank you for now unto you. You are able to keep us from falling, to keep us from stumbling. To you be honor, glory, dominion, and power. Oh, hallelujah, exceeding great joy. You are, hallelujah. Thanks be to God. You are. Oh, God, there's no guessing. There's no supposing. There's no might be. There's no if. There's no doubt. You are the only wise God. And I am privileged. And so many of us are privileged to have this experience, to be called, to be children of God. For you are the only wise God. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.